We were talking in an earlier episode about warrior women, specifically about the legends of the ancient Amazons. And we were kind of wondering, could it really be true above and beyond Wonder Woman? Were there really, as the legends say, a race of warrior women that were the equal of men and who took on men in full out army versus army manner, equal to equal, toe to toe? And I'm going to try to make the case. I believe it's true. Now, we do know, because they keep getting excavated by archaeologists in the Ukraine, around the Black Sea, graves of warrior women from around 1200 BC, the exact time that Homer says they existed, where a woman is buried in armor, with weapons, with horses. So that certainly would say, would lobby for it. But also in Athens, there are graves of the Amazons, or there are shrines to the Amazons. So let me tell you this part of the legend, because it's a really interesting story anyway. The legend is that an army of women, an army of Amazons, attacked Athens around the time, around 1200 BC. And the story goes like this. One of the first great kings of Athens was Theseus. Theseus, who slew the Minotaur in the labyrinth, that Theseus. And he supposedly led an expedition, kind of like Jason and the Argonauts, to the Black Sea by ship to the land of the Amazons. And supposedly, this expedition made contact with the Amazon women, and whose queen was either Antiope or Hippolyta. The same name is applied to the same female. Supposedly, Antiope fell in love with Theseus, and he took her back to Athens as his queen. Now, there's some debate over whether this he kidnapped her or whether she willingly came, but in any event, supposedly, the Amazons who were left behind, in outrage, raised an army, and they went to Athens, 3 months, cross-country, and attacked Athens. And so here I want to read, this is a passage from Plutarch. Now, Plutarch lived in the first century AD. He was a Roman. So that would be 1,200, 1,300 years after the supposed invasion. But Athens was still very much a going concern. He lived there. He knew what the city was exactly like. And this is what he says and what he wrote in The Life of Theseus. This was the origin of the Amazonian invasion of Athens, which would seem to have been no slight or womanish enterprise, for it is impossible that the Amazons should have placed their camp in the very city and joined battle close to the Pnyx. The Pnyx, P-N-Y-X, is where the Athenian assembly was, so the absolute heart of the city. Unless, having first conquered the country around about, they thus had with impunity advanced into the city. This is the sentence that's important to me. That they encamped there is certain and may be confirmed by the names that the places about yet retain, and the graves and monuments of those that fell in the battle. For indeed, we are also told that a number of the Amazons who died were buried there in the place that is to this time called Amazonium. So I would say, if we think about the names in America that are names of place names named after Indians, Native Americans, Seattle, Oneonta, anything with Iroquois, Kansas, Iowa, all of those names, they wouldn't have been named that unless there actually were real Native Americans who were there, right? So why would people in Athens name a section of the city after Amazons and have graves and temples to the Amazons unless it really happened? So anyway, I'm a believer that somehow, in some way, 1200 BC, an army of women attacked Athens. Supposedly, after that, in the immediate aftermath, 100 years, 50 years, the Amazons sort of faded away. And supposedly on their march back to the Black Sea, a three-month march after their defeat or failure to take Athens, their enemies kind of picked them off one tribe at a time, one battalion at a time. So maybe that's true, maybe it's not true, but I love that whole story. I definitely am a believer, under the heading of the warrior archetype, that there were no nonsense female warriors, the equal of men, who took them on head to head in real time.